everybody! I'm here today to tell you that most drivers make this silly mistake, and this silly mistake can absolutely ruin their car over the long run, in the long term. Without further ado, let's get right into the video. I'm going to tell you what the mistake is, then I'm actually going to demonstrate myself making that mistake, because that's how much I care about you guys. I want you to see what it actually looks like. Then I'll tell you why it can potentially ruin your car. It can likely ruin your car over the long term. Now, the mistake is simple. It is going from reverse to drive without stopping the wheels from moving. And oftentimes people will do this when they are reversing out of a parking spot or when they are actually reversing out of a driveway. And I'm gonna demonstrate right now. There's actually a car that's pulling into the parking lot. I'm just gonna let them go past and then I will demonstrate. But when you're pulling out of a driveway or a parking spot, you're gonna put the car in reverse and you're gonna have to move backwards. But then, you should come to a complete stop, but most people just put it into drive and just boogie onwards. You know, they just rock and roll forward, right? So they're reversing like this out of the parking spot, you know, and all of a sudden they're going like this, and then they just throw it in drive and they start driving. And the wheels never actually stop moving. And another example is if they're in reverse like this, they throw it in drive and they go into the spot. Or they're in drive and then they put it in reverse without stopping, right? And they push the gas. Now, obviously, in a real life situation, people would be accelerating much harder, because if you're reversing out of a driveway and you start driving on the road, you're gonna accelerate much harder. So what I'll do is I'll actually show you a real life example. So let's say I'm reversing like this. I definitely don't wanna hit the car behind me. So I'm reversing like this, throw it in drive, and let's rock and roll. You know, they do that. And what happens is you're changing the direction of the transmission, okay? I'm just gonna loop around the parking lot and park in that same spot. Hopefully it's still available. You're changing the direction of the wheels, of the way that they're moving, okay? But you're not letting the car stop moving. And that's what the problem is, that when you do something like that, it's gonna affect the transmission in a negative way. And I'll tell you exactly why. Okay, sorry about that. I just had to wave at some people that I was passing by. It's gonna affect the transmission in a negative way, because it's like you're walking backwards and all of a sudden someone pushes you forward. It's similar to doing that to your body, but that's what's gonna happen with the transmission. And it's very unfortunate, because it has become sort of like a regular part of driving. People do it all the time, and eventually you're gonna ruin your transmission. Now, your transmission is made up of many different small, tiny little components, okay? Different kinds of gears and cogs and bends and all sorts of stuff. And when you do that, you're really putting a lot of pressure on those components. And what happens is, eventually with enough pressure, you know, it fails. And I will tell you, replacing a transmission or fixing a transmission is very, 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 very expensive. So with that being said, just avoid doing it. Now, obviously, going from reverse to drive without stopping is way more common than going from drive to reverse. I find that, I see this happen every day. That's why I'm telling you this. It's not based on a survey, it's just based on what I see. You know, when you're going from drive to reverse, almost everybody comes to complete stop, because you're all of a sudden you're looking back, right? So they come to complete stop and then they start going in reverse. But from reverse to drive, people just don't come to complete stop. It's just they're in a rush. I'll give you one more example. Let's say I'm straightening out in a parking spot. Let's make sure there's nobody around here. So I'm straightening out and all of a sudden you throw it in drive and you start moving forward. And I never braked there. Like, I didn't fully brake. I was in reverse and I went from reverse to drive just like that. And I let the drivetrain start moving the car forward instead of the brakes. And eventually it's gonna catch up to you. Now, if you do it once or twice, it's not a big deal. Like, I did it, I don't know, 5 times in this video. If you do it a few times, it's really nothing. Like, the transmission is meant to withstand that. But if you do it every day for 5 years, yeah, it's gonna cause some problems. And it's not just automatic, right? It's not just an automatic car. The same thing follows with a manual car as well. You really wanna avoid doing this in a manual car too, just a random little side note. But that's it. That is a silly mistake that most drivers make pretty much on a daily basis that can eventually ruin their car. The problem is, most drivers make this mistake, 10 years later, their transmission's like basically falling out of their car. And they're like, wow, how did I treat my car so well? How is it breaking down? You're making one little mistake over and over and over again, and eventually catches up to you. So avoid that silly mistake please. And that's it. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great car and driving videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.